A 42-year-old comes to the office for wisdom teeth removal. His x-ray looks suspicious, so I get a 3D reconstruction, and there's a bizarre growth on his mandible. What is this, and is this a sign of something much more serious? Check out the full case today on the Open Reduction. Welcome to the Open Reduction, your channel covering all topics oral and maxillofacial surgery. I'm Dr. Tom Bolten, and today we're talking about a very interesting case that demonstrates how we can spot syndromes based on an oral exam. This patient is a 42-year-old male who was referred to my office for wisdom teeth removal. He's been having some issues with pain and swelling. He has some other medical problems, but we'll get to those in a minute. His dentist was also concerned about an abnormal finding on his panoramic x-ray. There are multiple suspicious radio-opaque lesions throughout his mandible. I obtain a cone beam CT and see this surprising growth. I discussed treatment options with him, and he elected to proceed with removal of his wisdom teeth and also removal of this lesion in the office under IV sedation. I removed the wisdom teeth, and here is this growth after I expose it. I removed it with a burr and submitted the tissue to the pathologist. This lesion came back as an osteoma, a benign tumor of bone. Based on the radiograph, he has several more of these in earlier stages of development. So, based on his radiograph and the pathology results, what else would you expect this patient to have in his health history? Is it A, colon polyps, B, basal cell carcinoma, C, aplastic clavicles, D, neurofibromas, or E, proptosis? If you said A, then you are correct. This patient has a history of multiple colon polyps, which can progress to malignant cancer. His polyps were so numerous, his entire colon was removed. He reports his brother has the exact same problem. He's not aware of any syndrome, but obviously knows there's a genetic component. So the next question, what syndrome does he have? Is it A, Gorlin-Golz syndrome, B, Crouzon syndrome, C, Gardner syndrome, D, neurofibromatosis, or E, cleidocranial dysplasia? If you got the first question right, you probably got this one as well. This patient suffers from Gardner syndrome, a rare genetic condition. Gardner syndrome is a rare phenotypic variant of familial adenomatous polyposis, which is what he thought he originally had. Gardner syndrome is more rare and is characterized by numerous polyps in the colon with high malignancy potential. On exam, I was also able to palpate a growth on his skull consistent with another osteoma. These patients are also at an increased risk for additional malignancies, such as liver cancer, adrenal tumors, and thyroid cancer. This patient will need to follow up with his primary care team for regular liver, thyroid, and ocular testing. The lifespan of a patient with untreated Gardner syndrome is about 45 years, due to the inevitable development of malignant colon cancer. However, patients can live much longer with treatment, which usually involves removal of the colon, as in this case. Early detection of additional tumors is key, so these osteomas were a blessing in disguise. He will now follow up regularly with his medical team to screen for additional tumors that are associated with Gardner syndrome. Thanks so much for watching. Please click those like and subscribe buttons. Check out the channel for more interesting OMFS cases like this one. And also keep an eye on my website, theopenreduction.com, which is coming soon. I'm Dr. Tom Bolten. I'll catch you next time on The Open Reduction.